IPL season. Very busy schedule, and thank you for spending time with us. So I'm Alan. I'm a part of the Product Folks team. I have joined myself with Suhas. Suhas founded Product Folks, and a bit of Product Folks. A Product Folks is a volunteer-driven product community, and we are a bunch of aspiring product managers, marketeer, designers. We just club together, and a bunch of initiatives from our end. Let me quickly open the site. Yes, let me know if my screen is visible. Cool, awesome. So one of our biggest milestones slash achievements is happening next week by now. We are conducting our product summit with in partnership with Inc42. And maybe in the end of by the end of this event, if Suhas has any coupons or any surprises, we'll let you all know. And yeah, we also have a few initiatives like 100 InSergio, which is a APM program. We also have initiatives like learning IR learning program with other folks within the community. We have 19 chapters. We have conducted more than 100 events, and we have four verticals. One is a product teardown session which we are doing right now. We also have a product conversation session that is only with folks like Marty Kagan and Shishir and folks like that. We also have breaking into PM with me, another event that's going on sites. So a lot of things are going on. Do check our sites out, and we have 52 people in this call right now. And a bit about this event. So product teardown is basically, the idea behind this event is we thought developers have a platform called GitHub, designers have a platform called Dribbble. Do product managers have, can they showcase their skill? That was the idea. That was the, that piqued our curiosity. So we thought what we do best, we do events, that's our forte. What if we just combine that with a session where people quickly can prepare a deck and they can present it live with the person from the product team of that product. That's the thought process. And last month we had Dunzo, and this month we have Hotstar. And about when we end the session, in the end, I'll send you all the link for the upcoming session for the month of October. And those who are interested, feel free to join the upcoming teardown as well. Thank you so much. Over to you, Suhas.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Alan. I think that was a great intro. And like Alan shared, the idea for the teardown came. We have a bunch of initiatives. Learn PM with me, which is a learning resource for early stage product managers. We have InSergio, which is an early stage APM program. What we want to do with the teardown series is get some more practical learning as well as feedback from the industry. So without further ado, for all folks who've signed up for the Hotstar, thanks so much for participating. I think we got some great decks. Only for the paucity of time, we have three that we've shortlisted within the panel, as well as with Shobit's recommendation. He will be sharing more about the scoring as we go along. But all the best to the top three who've been shortlisted, and we'll get started with the event. But for everyone else who participated, thank you so much. We do have a couple of interesting things lined up as well, and hope that take this more as a learning experience. The winning bit and all of that is just as an incentive, which is right on top. We try to motivate, but if you guys have any other ideas that we could do which you think might be useful, feel free to write to us. This entire thing is completely volunteer driven, so feel free to get involved in any way. And without further ado, getting started with today's session. Today's teardown is on Hotstar's product. I think for folks who've seen the entire teardown process, you all know the problem statement. We have our top three finalists today with us who've joined us. We'll be calling out their names. One very small shuffle to get them started. So I'll come back to that bit. But just wanted to quickly bring our mentor for today, Shobit. Hi, Shobit.
Hey, Suhas. Hey, Alan.
Awesome. Thank you so much for joining in, Shobhit. So guys, we, as Alan shared the agenda, once we are done with this session, we'll have a quick chat with Shobhit to understand how his career, some interesting things that they've been doing at Hotstar. So if you have any questions, I think Alan will also be sharing a Slido link. So do stick around for that. I think he's had a very interesting journey. And with the IPL season around, I think everyone wants to know what Hotstar is up to. So whatever he can share, some interesting insights from there. So yeah, I think power packed 90 minutes. Thank you everyone for joining us, and we're kicking this off.
Suhas, just one quick question. Can you pin the Slido link on the chat section?
I'll do that. Perfect. Thanks. Awesome.
I'd love to say hi to everyone, Suhas, once.
Yes. So I was actually going to intro. So I think over to you, Shobhit, right over to you. So if you could just walk us through through your thoughts as well as the scoring bit, that would be awesome.
Awesome. Firstly, hi to everyone here. I can see around 70 odd people. That's definitely overwhelming response by any measure. And thanks for choosing to spend the first day of your long weekend with all of us. In fact, I think there's a couple of my own team members who joined us. I'm wondering if they haven't had enough of me speaking already in the last 6 months or so. But glad to have everyone here overall. And the deck submitted and the participation was super encouraging. I think I honestly didn't really know what to expect when I first signed up for this with Alan and Suhas, but it was really enriching going through feedback. As product managers, we're almost always trying to find new ways of talking to our users and understanding what people are saying about the product and what they would like to see change. So if anything else, for me, this was a great source of feedback and just understanding how people like us are thinking about the product itself, and fresh perspective always adds a lot of value. To provide a little bit of insight in terms of how I was looking at the presentations, I think I largely had four heads or four verticals under which I was trying to score, if I could use that term, these various presentations. The first and most important for me was just user empathy in terms of being able to understand the real pain points that users are facing, or what users are thinking, what users are saying or feeling at a given point of time, and being able to contextualize that to make it real in terms of this is the actual pain point felt by users, or this is what users like about the product. I think that sets a lot of context, and that is the best thing that we could hope to start off with. So a lot of emphasis was placed on that first and foremost. Segueing from that, the next thing that we focused on was, you know, at Hotstar, while we're trying to innovate in terms of doing things differently or innovating in a way such that you achieve results in a cost-effective manner or you achieve higher impact for the kind of effort that's put in. But the reality is that we're not the first people in the world to try and build out video streaming or OTT. So while we will innovate in various areas and we'll be very selective about where we choose to completely reinvent the wheel on, we don't need to do it for 90% of the things that we do. So it's really important for us to understand benchmarks and understand the thought process behind whether the solution being proposed is actually the best way to solve the problem enunciated under user empathy or not. And that, I think, was something that's super important for us, because it's relatively easy to shoot from the hip. But in a world when there are 1,000 things happening, it's really important to be focused and try and learn from either the mistakes committed in the past or the insights gained in the past by people who've done similar things. And that's honestly the best way to grow. So that's something that we actually put a lot of value on, which is that learn from people's successes, learn from people's mistakes, and then move forward from there so that you're able to do better and not just as good as someone else. The third for us, which is super important, is an understanding of what metrics do we think will move by virtue of these different initiatives we're thinking of. And while it's easy to hypothesize relatively, it's almost equally important for us to be able to identify and pinpoint objectively which metrics we're trying to chase by virtue of the suggestions, by virtue of any of the initiatives that we're talking about. Or even if there is a user pain point that has been articulated qualitatively, it's important to try and break it down or at least compare some objective metric that we can then track week on week, month on month, in order to quantitatively say that we have solved this problem. And the last one, of course, is just as product managers, we're storytellers, right? It's important for us to not just understand the information that we're thinking about, but also present it in a way such that other people around us are convinced. We're evangelists first and foremost. So that really was the last piece, and all of these kind of went into scoring the different presentations. I hope that provides some context in terms of the exercise up until now. And for the three folks, like, thanks for participating and putting in your best foot forward. For the three folks that we have who will present for us today, I would be highly focused on exactly these questions, right? I'd want to understand how we're trying to build this user empathy. I want to spend a lot more time on the metrics and what kind of key results we can drive by virtue of those ideas or those initiatives that are being proposed, and then take the conversation forward from there.
Perfect. Thanks so much, Shobhit. I think that sets the context and that helps a lot. So all the best, guys. And do keep it relevant to this. So that might help in the points that you're getting scored against. Above all, keep this super interactive, guys. I think this is one of our most informal sessions, at least. That's how we're trying to build this track. So even if you haven't participated in this time, most of us use Hotstar as a product. So feel free to add your questions. Be nice. Try to be nice and critique, yes, but be nice because everyone's putting the best foot forward. But yeah, let's keep it super interactive. Chat sections open for everyone. And let's get started. So for this time, go ahead.
Even over the course of the presentations, I'm not sure if people are able to send their chat messages, but it would be great to receive questions on the Slido link that Alan had shared earlier. Or even in this chat section, and we're more than happy to try and cover those in detail. But exactly. We'd love for the first part of the session to focus on the decks, and I can speak about my journey and my introductions a bit later. I don't want to spend too much time on that right now.
Right. That's why we kept like an exclusive session. So guys, any questions around the decks, please shoot it on the chat. But we'd love if you guys have any questions around, you know, Hotstar or, you know, product carriers, how Shobhit's journey has been, feel free to add to the Slido. And this time we'll be picking everything from there. We're keeping it super interactive, trying to bring as many of your opinions as well as questions, trying to, you know, keep this super interactive. I think I've used that too many times. So without further ado, jumping straight in. So our three finalists, we're doing a random order for them. So I'll just share my screen and that will give you our top three folks who, you can see my screen, right? Yep. So Himanshu, Ananya and Gauri, congrats for being shortlisted at the top three. We're going to run a quick random order. So I will hit randomize and that would be the order for today's session. And here we go. So that is the, did it? Yeah, okay. Okay, I'll run it once again, in case that shifts. So we'll do like the best of three and the third one will be the one we'll do. Okay, it's only the second and third that's getting shifted, but that is the order that we're going with. So first Himanshu, second Gauri, Ananya. You guys get 10 minutes to present, a total of 8+2, where we might have some questions from our speakers as well. At the end of 10 minutes, there will be a hard stop. I will probably come back right on screen. In case you have any questions, feel free to add it to the chat section. Himanshu, just if I will be bringing you on screen in case you're ready. I think we've already tested in the screen share, so that should be okay. Himanshu, awesome.
Hey, hi guys, and thank you for this opportunity. I felt the randomizer told me that I was the chosen one, like they just didn't budge. So yeah, I'm very excited to be here and had a lot of fun doing this teardown. Awesome. I'll be just sharing my screen now.
Sure, your time starts now and you have 10 minutes to start.
Okay, great. So I'll just quickly first start away right away with the agenda. As we know, the key goal is to improve user engagement and retention. I'll just quickly run through the consumer persona that we considered, someone living in a tier 1 and 2 city, using this account either for themselves or sharing this with friends and family. They have a premium or a VIP subscription and they're consuming most of this content either on mobile or some other platforms. Just quickly move on to the consumer journey. I think there are two very prevalent use cases. One is the search-led use case wherein a customer is aware of specific content that they want to seek, be it like IPL, or hostages or any other content. And the second one is the suggestion-led use case, wherein they don't exactly know what they want to watch, but they come onto the platform, basis a suggestion, they latch onto that content. The user journey has two critical steps which follow a feedback loop. So one is exploring content. Any OTT's aspiration here should be that even if I don't know as a customer what to watch, I would still want to log into Hotstar because I know they have great content and I love the suggestions that they provide. The next step is viewing content, wherein I believe that even if this content is freely available across any platform, I'll still watch it on Hotstar because this UI is so great. So these two steps of the journey are really critical for improving my engagement and retention. Going further into engagement, it is driven by customization because often there's a use case wherein multiple users are logging in via a single account. So what sort of suggestions, what sort of watch list or download is customized for them impacts their experience, and also how they're able to stay on top of what their friends are watching, what is the trending content, increases their retention on the platform. The next step is a quick search and suggestion. What sort of suggestions are they getting? What sort of new categories are they getting exposed to? And that helps a lot. Retention basically is driven by what sort of exclusive content is there, which I cannot find anywhere else. And also like a few small section which I talked with, they told me that even if I'm not regularly using it, I know my friends and family is, so I keep the account and I keep paying for the subscription. So what we'll do now is evaluate these metrics along these two journeys as well only. So now first talking about account customization. So Hotstar right now does not offer multiple user profile. And this sometimes leads to an incoherent UI for multi-login accounts, wherein I will get suggestion basis watch experience of other users who are logging in. And this can lead to incoherent suggestions as well. Similarly, for like premium customers are those who have paid one of the most expensive fees for a subscription. And premium content is not directly available on the homepage. It's a two-tap process. You go into the hamburger menu and then click on the premium content. So I believe this should be present in the front to reduce post-purchase dissonance. Also, I did three screen rolls of the depth and content of the category to understand what's happening. So like for the homepage, if you would see, there is repetition of content. Like across three scrolls, I could see hostages appearing twice. Also, the categories were adjacent, not distinct, like special and latest movies, multiplex movies. So overall, I had a browser fatigue going through this and probably not the ideal use case for me when I'm doing a suggestion-led search. So while I understand Hotstar is trying to emphasize more on their exclusive content and get user to watch that, but for me, it felt like there's a limited content. The same scroll when I did on the premium page, I saw a lot of distinct content. I saw very helpful category suggestions like Love is in the Air, Rise of the Mutant, Emmy nominated, IMDb. So that led me to have an encouraging experience over here. Next is quick search. So while we know mobile screen sizes are getting larger by the day, the lower area where my thumb can move is where I want to have quick actions, like I can download, search, move through the account. And the upper half is where I lay my eye on immediately when I open the platform, right? So Hotstar right now has all these key navigation actions on the very top, like your search and your hamburger, which leads to languages and other genres. Whereas your category are listed at the bottom tab, but not very clearly contrasted in here. Talking about assisted search. So if you tap on the search button on the homepage, on the first tab, you have this first pop-up and then you have to again tap to get the keyboard opening. A user search going on to search is looking to type something. So I've suggested a mock UI wherein on the first tab, you have this keyboard open as well as all the sorting by languages and categories to expose user to more content which is available on Hotstar. The same goes for category. While I tapped onto the category page, the existing UI which I had was not clearly sorted by genres or languages. So I did a sorting wherein you click on television, then you get a sorting of genres which are available and the languages in which the content is available as well to help you with your choices. Next is watching in your languages. So right now the process is that you go on to hamburger menu, click on languages and then have access to that content, which again is not clearly sorted. I've suggested creating a carousel on the homepage, which you can scroll through, select the language you want, and then you have like shows in Hindi, movies in Hindi, news in Hindi, and even the movies dubbed in Hindi, which gives a much better experience for the customer. Now coming on to a new section, which I propose to create, which is called trending. The idea here is to increase retention on the platform and have higher engagement with friends. So transferring the friend list either from Facebook or via contact list you get to see your friends' activity, what are the top trending by category context in India today, and you can drop or receive suggestions from your friend as to what is the latest show that they have. Similarly, have a look at the live sports which is going on, live news. So idea is to have a very engaging conversation with your friends and you see what they're up to, what's trending right now. The next thing which I thought of is that in the watch list section, we could create a further UI. I've created a mock UI here, wherein I see curated watch list by celebrities, which is enticing for the user, like Vidas top five from Hotstar Premium. Also, I get to curate multiple options for myself in the watch list, and then an option to share it across platforms. So here's this famous politician on Tinder, and he's flaunting what he's watching on Hotstar this week, because it's a conversation starter. People, that's how they're talking right now, like what you're watching, what's the latest content. Similarly, you can curate a shared watch list with your friends and they can add on content and you can see what they're watching, what they're loving. So overall, this increases your retention because you want to be a part of this community longer. This is a mock UI of the existing homepage. Please refer it in the sequential number that I've put in here. So like we can see categories are listed at the bottom, but not clearly contrasted. At the very top, you would see that there's a search bar and the navigation menus here. And there is no clear language sorting available here. However, I noticed that both downloads and watch list here are a part of the home feed itself and not like other apps are doing a dedicated buttons for them. So I did a working on the mock UI that I wanted to create. This is the feedback. So if you go again in the same sequential number, I've listed categories which are the top four use cases at the very top. Then there is a banner which is like bases the time or the location. So it's in the morning, there might be news. If it's IPL time, there might be a banner of the game. And like say I'm 45 minutes away from my home, bases your location, you can suggest me one episode of the latest TV series I'm watching. And then at the bottom, you have stories of the top categories because Hotstar has a lot of categories. So they can explore more categories via the blip on the right. And on each categories you click, you get stories with the subsections which are available. Also, I created a language carousel at the bottom. Then at the bottom tab, you can see an account, you can see a search bar, the trending button which we discussed, and an option to download and access quickly your content which is available. Another thing which I noticed would be critical here is the existing UI wherein you want to access key navigation from outside the app. Not everyone might be using it, but I thought it was one functionality which we could introduce and talk about. So this was the exploring part. Now coming on to the view content part. So content merchandising plays a very critical role here because like if you can see, Prime has IMDb, Netflix has their own match ratings, Hotstar has none. Similarly, you have the ability to rate shows, know what you like or don't like. Prime offers you to binge download an entire season for Hotstar. You'll have to do that like one by one. And Netflix also helps you become more confident about your choices by telling you that this is a trending content. So these changes in content merchandising could really help. Next is like uninterrupted viewing experience. Watching lazily is the best way to watch it. If I have to scroll through multiple episodes or go back episode, right now I'll have to change the orientation of my screen because the option is to only switch to next episode. Whereas on Netflix with the same view screen, I can scroll through all the possible episodes which are available. Similarly, I observed that when you click on a particular content while you're watching, there's an observation to watch the same content in multiple languages. Very smart on part of Hotstar, like English is available only with premium and VIP offers Hindi and other languages. I thought that here you can introduce theme-based suggestions, like in addition to more like this, if I'm watching Black Panther, more for Chadwick Boseman, more for Marvel or superheroes, to give more offers to the consumer to explore category. This was all. Now coming on to prioritization, which is the last slide that I have. So I have two metrics here. I'm evaluating metric by impact on engagement and retention, and then on execution, this is the time and resources required. So account customization fares the highest, like that's what gives the maximum impact on both engagement and retention. New section trending, which we talked about, yes, it gives a high impact, but yeah, it would require more resources. Assisted search similarly gives a higher impact. Going for shared watch list, higher impact, but would take more time. And the same, you can see the themes going across. As we see, the lowest impact would be for faster access and one-tap access to premium, but these will have like the least time to do. So that's all from my end. I hope I'm on time, yeah?
Yeah, perfect. Thank you so much, Manchu. So sorry, I'm still trying to figure out best ways to do the timer. And Bell was on feedback I got last time. I hope that was non-intrusive. But yeah, thank you so much. I guess we didn't have too much time for questions on this one, Shobhit. Do you quickly want to do just one question on this deck, if you have any?
Yeah, I think what I really liked about Manchu's presentation, and even today and even earlier when I was reviewing this, is that
there's just a lot of thought that's gone into covering the breadth of or the gamut of things that we could possibly work on. They resonate a lot in terms of how people are thinking about it at Hotstar itself, not just on my own teams, but across other teams as well. And it's great to see this come together and be put into one view. One question for Himanshu is that, Himanshu, if you could, out of all of these things that you have on this slide, right, if you could pick that one thing that could be a needle mover for you, pick that one thing out for me and then tell me what is the exact metric, both an input and output metric, that you think is going to be affected by virtue of that initiative.
Okay. Can you hear me? I think I lost your video. Yeah, that's fine. So thank you. While I'm not a traditional PM, I'm into product marketing, but I did an estimation as to the resources required. So clearly, like all the conversations I had, I know that account customization would give the maximum output. And if that is taken care of, the next thing would be the new section. If I specifically talk about account customization, for me, the metric would be that once I have an individual logging in via the account customization, I would want to see basis of suggestions that I'm giving them, how many users are accessing that content via the first two scrolls, because that's where now all my focus would be. I've created a customized page for them. So I would want to know, are they accessing those tabs on the homepage which are customized for them? It will be telling me that either my account customization hypothesis was right or it is wrong. If I see larger interaction on those carousels or on those tabs on the first two scrolls, that tells me that it's working and people are getting what they want within the first scroll itself, which is an indication that engagement is increasing. They're not wasting time moving around and eventually getting out because of browser fatigue.
Got it. All right. This is super helpful, Himanshu. Thanks.
Thank you.
So as give us a timer at 8 minutes also, no, if possible. Maybe you could just put it in the chat. So
okay. Awesome. Awesome. I'll do that. Thanks.
Thank you.
Yeah, perfect. Thanks so much, Himanshu. That was a great deck. And all the best. We'll be announcing the results at the end of it and maybe some more feedback. So yeah, good luck. Thanks so much once again. So moving on to our second participant for today. As per the list, I think we have Gauri. So I'll just be letting her in. Just give me a minute. Gauri, if you're on the call, please could you just hit yes in the chat section? If you're ready on your side. Awesome. Just letting you on. All set. Yep, we can see you. And I've just given you rights to share your screen as well. So over to you. Quick 30-second intro into your what you're doing, and the next 10 minutes, 8+2 is yours. All the best.
Yeah, sure.
You can see your screen.
There's nothing much to my intro. I'm a final year undergrad student at BITS Pilani. That's pretty much it.
Hi, Gauri. Nice to have you here.
Do I go ahead with my presentation?
Yep, go for it. All the best.
Okay, so I'll just start off with a brief outline of my approach and an explanation for how I sought to take on the problem statement. So as we all know, Hotstar exists in a very competitive market, and this means that consumers are expecting delivery on both large-scale ideas as well as the minutiae of design for solving those large-scale ideas. So my technique approaches both UI UX design nuances as well as wider reaching feature metrics. I have informed my research based on my personal experience and interviews with a few acquaintances. So I'll start off with analyzing Hotstar as a product from the point of view of user personas, then move on to analyzing on two fronts, which will be my foundation for my major recommendation, and then a brief conclusion. So moving on to the product analysis, I have classified the user personas for any given OTT under, especially Hotstar, under five buckets. The first 3 are users I won't be focusing all that much on in this review. That'll be the soap watcher, a preteen, and someone who's looking into regional content. The 2 users I will be focusing more on will be a media buff and a sports buff. So media buff is someone I'm defining as a user who goes into OTTs for finding and consuming premium movie and show content. And a sports buff is obviously someone who wants to keep up with live screenings and archived games. So some of the assumptions and constraints I will be working within going forward. One is that Hotstar's mobile UI is by far its most popular interface. So I'll be sticking to an Android UI. From the previous slide, I'll be focusing on the media buff personality because it has the most generic user stories and can apply to most users. Last is I'll be trying to stay away from personalize and recommend your content kind of improvement suggestion, because I'm assuming like all other OTTs, Hotstar is currently working on it, and any suggestion without very hardcore technical insights would be kind of redundant. So starting with the analysis, like I said, I'll be analyzing both the design and functionality. For the design, I'll go with a user journey review. And for functionality, I'll be using the Google's heart metrics. With the user journey review, I'll be giving a sort of small and concise observations and recommendations. And with the heart analysis, I'll lay the groundwork for my large scale recommendation. With the user journey review, like I said, I'll be going with the media buff. So the user stories I have analyzed are 3 major buckets. One is decisive viewing, where the user has opened the app with a specific movie or show in mind. Another is a more abstract idea of what kind of content they would want to watch. And the third is something that is probably more popular right now. That is when they just have some time to kill and have opened up Hotstar. It's kind of like a freely browsing scenario. So starting with decisive viewing, I'll go with someone who wants to watch a specific show. So when you land on the homepage, the first thing that you notice is the continue watching section, which I would say is very optimally placed. And something that Hotstar has, a feature that Hotstar has unique as opposed to other OTTs, is its editing feature for this continue watching section. It was unique up till very recently when Netflix also introduced that feature.
I mean, they copied us, right?
I guess so. Assuming that they did not find what they were looking for in the continue watching section, they would go obviously to the search function. Here, there's a kind of cluttered UI while you're typing in your inputs. One major contributor to that, I would say, is because both shows and their specific episodes are being shown in the search interface. I would think that restricting it to just shows and allowing users to go into the shows to look for specific episodes would make for a smoother user flow. Once a user has found a show, the interface that comes up is different from what Prime or Netflix would offer. And I think a user would prefer this for kind of browsing the details of the content that they have opened up, because there's a video widget on top and then they can look into the details. One thing I would suggest though is right now when you press the play function, the interface remains the same and the video starts playing. But I would think most users would want to start viewing in a full screen and have the option to minimize whenever they would want to. Next, all settings features that are available can be manipulated pretty easily. And as opposed to other OTTs, it can function without actually interrupting your viewing session. So that is a big plus point for the Hotstar interface. A feature that is missing would be the picture-in-picture feature, which has very obvious advantages. So the user can continue engaging with the content while they're multitasking. For the genre browse, I'll go with a movie watching experience just to cover more ground. So one glaring hitch is when you go on the main page, you can't really see a movies tab. You'll have to go into the hamburger menu. To me, a more logical UI flow would be to bucket all the entertainment categories in the navigation bar. So that would be TV, Disney Plus, sports, and movies, and have the more informational content at the top as some sort of icon. So this would allow users to view all categories, but still have an intuitive feel to the UI. Once someone goes within the movie section and to a particular genre, two major recommendations that I would have is one, to have a filter option at the top of every single page. Right now, Hotstar has a lot of category pages, so genre, languages, and so on, but they don't have the option to filter within those. So I would think any user would want to cross criterion filter between the content type, language, and genre at all times. Another related feature is that each content is only tagged with a single genre, which in today's mediascape, I would say is not really sufficient. Lastly, when I'm within a genre, if I were to go in thinking that I wanted to watch an English comedy drama, I still have to scroll through a lot of multilingual content. I would say giving the users the option to choose a few languages at the beginning of their Hotstar experience so that their entire UX is constricted to those languages would be more useful. But since Hotstar tries to leverage its more regional content, it can still be recommended based on popularity, but a few restrictions can be put based on the content, the kind of languages that the user is comfortable with. So that was for the smaller scale analysis. Moving on to a large scale analysis, I'll be using Google's HART metrics. I'll just briefly review what the metric means. So it starts off with happiness, which is a measure of how satisfied a user is with the experience, engagement with the user with the platform's content, adoption of new users into the platform, retention of existing users, and task completion. Starting with happiness, that is satisfaction of UX, two major recommendations I would have is obviously very briefly using ML and user activity to streamline recommendations. And the other is profile separation for shared accounts, since that's extremely common in a market like India. With user engagement, Hotstar is kind of, in my view, kind of on the line. While it beautifully streamlines the new Disney Plus content for children, it does not do that for slightly older users who might want to use that content. And on a related note, a freely browsing user might also need a little bit help with the interface. Adoption is something that Hotstar very famously is good at, especially with its freemium sports content and handling of regional content. Also, the RFM-based interactions with users is very optimal for nudging users along the funnel to subscriptions. Retention is something I would say Hotstar might have to work on, especially with respect to a user who has no specific stimulus to return to Hotstar on a regular basis. So they are not sports watchers or a regular soap watchers. As I said earlier, the task success metric is very well fulfilled by Hotstar. So for my major recommendation, I am...
Gauri, just a quick heads up. You're just at the 10-minute mark right now. So this might be a wrap-up slide for you. So in case you have other slides coming up, if you could...
This is my last slide, yeah.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah. So I'll be trying to improve engagement and retention of the users I mentioned earlier who have no specific reason to come back to Hotstar consistently. I'll first spitball with a few ideas. So one is obviously improve personalization, which I mentioned earlier why I will not be tackling. The other is integration with platforms like Letterboxd, but that would the success of that kind of system would be based on how many users use Letterboxd and how much interlap there is between their watch list there and the amount of content on Hotstar. The other is a very common like-dislike feature, which I'm again discarding because I'd say it's an overused feature, which does not really improve recommendation systems all that much. The feature I'll be focusing on is age-based leveraging of the new Disney Plus content. I'll be calling this a Neverland recommender. The basic idea is to input the user's age and make a catalog of content that they would have watched at different phases in their life. And obviously there's a lot of marketing campaigns that can go hand in hand with this kind of a feature. Why I would justify that Hotstar use this feature would be one, browsing millennial is one of their major users right now. And this like they would be extremely open to viewing content that they that have a nostalgia factor. Do you remember section in the main page is, will incite curiosity in any user, and declining a subscription for a service that is associated with nostalgia will obviously be more difficult for a user. This will also provide a separate niche for Hotstar for non-sports users, like a nostalgia niche, which will separate it from other OTTs. And very briefly, validation metrics for this kind of a feature would be the percentage of subscription renewals in millennials and their engagement with Disney Plus content.
Awesome. Yep.
Gauri, yeah, that was great. Yeah. Off the cuff, Gauri, I think kudos to you. I think this was amongst the most detailed context setting or at least user empathy evaluations that I've seen across the decks. And that was really, really good. I also really liked how you dug into the user journeys and you were able to provide your own notes in terms of what you thought was working well, what you thought could have been improved. And that was really good for me. I want to maybe ask a similar question that I asked Himanshu earlier, right? So you do have one recommendation that you've come up with in terms of this is a suggestion that could be done. I'm having a little bit of trouble in taking that logical jump in terms of the problems that you identified. How do you see them distilling down to the solution that you've arrived at?
I would say from my heart metric analysis, the major area of improvement would be retention of users. And here, retention and engagement at the same time. And I think a lot of surveys have said that millennials are the major consumer base for Hotstar. And a major change in today's world because of the pandemic would be how users view OTTs. Earlier, they might have used it for a more targeted search, but right now they tend to a browsing kind of using. And this would help a lot with that. And Hotstar as a platform is also trying, I'm assuming, is trying to leverage their new Disney Plus content. So this would be a way to use something that is already existing in a relatively easy manner.
If including your, I know that you skirted the suggestion around making recommendations better or stronger. Yeah. And in my mind, that's a super broad term, right? Like one could almost...
I know that this definitely falls under the umbrella, but I was referring more to based on user activity and user history, that kind of personalization. This personalization is sort of on a different plane, I would say.
All right. Super helpful. Thanks, Gauri. Let's head into our final deck for the evening and then we can chat about those.
Awesome. Thanks so much once again, Gauri, and Ananya is already here. Gauri, I think as Shobhit said, great deck and all the best. Ananya, thank you so much for joining in. I didn't have to search for your name. So welcome. You're the last on the panel, but all the best to you. Great deck. I've seen the deck. And quick 30-second intro and then the next 10 minutes are yours.
Yeah. Hi, everyone. I'm Ananya. I'm currently working as a product manager in Microsoft. And I'm also a poet and a pandemic artist. Like, I recently started drawing. So I'll just share my screen and
is pandemic artist like bathroom singer? It's something that you only do during this duration.
So I started in pandemic. I don't know if I'll continue or not.
Okay, we hope you continue. Please don't let go of your passion.
Is it visible? Sure. So I'll get started. The OTT platforms are something that comes off as a respite in the pandemic times, more so because it's been like a survival strategy as to earlier, the main motive being content consumption. So the main objective of this is to improve the user engagement and retention for the Disney Plus Hotstar app. Moving on to our user persona. He comes with his family, as said in Hindi, Sir Parivara Mantra. So Rahul is basically a 33-year-old IT professional. He's living in Bangalore with his wife, Reena, and two kids, Misha and Manav. He's an avid cricket and tennis fan and loves rewinding with a movie on weekends. So we'll just start from the right start. So he's just waiting for a client in a meeting, getting bored. And he thinks like, maybe I'll just watch cricket for the meantime. And he decides to install the Hotstar app. He goes to the app store and sees the ratings, sees the reviews, and decides to install the app. One of the observations here is there's some negative reviews which are not being replied by the company, as I would say. And this ratings are proven by research to be one of the first factors that new users sees and helps a lot in app discovery. So one recommendation would be for more long-term users, we could start with a better onboarding experience as well as replying to the message showing that the company listens. He installs the app. The first thing that comes is asking the location permission, which again is not a P0 permission and adds to one more step in the onboarding journey for the user. I feel that could be done later on, asking for the location inside. He logs in and there's no option to log in with Google, although Facebook and email is there. He finally adds his mobile number and gets an OTP. So the icon which is there for the OTP is actually the old Hotstar logo, which I just noticed. Finally, Rahul logs into the app and the onboarding process is quite intuitive and easy to use. But he just sees that the homepage does not have his personalized recommendation. And then he figures out, oh, he's not already logged in. So he moves on to the hamburger menu to see the login option. And one observation here is the login option is not visible clearly on the homepage, which is most probably the first thing that the user does. Although like the kids toggle and the search is available, probably we could have a login which is more clearly visible to the new users. The second thing is the adverts take one of the prime real estate in the homepage. Also, there's this pill that says play poker. So with the current news, like Google actually recommending Zomato and Swiggy to not have the in-app advertising, this again might be something that the company could look into. Moving next.
Ananya, do you mind if I interject quickly?
Sure.
Hey. So in the interest of time, right? So of course I've seen your deck. I've looked at it in detail. I was wondering if you want to focus on the sections that are more related to retention, the activation and onboarding journey, because I think that's more relevant to development and help.
Sure. I'll just skip to those. Yeah, I'll just move ahead. So Rahul finally logs into the app. One good thing that he sees is a section which is loved by cricket lovers. Himself being a cricket lover, he finds like a group of like-minded people and related recommendations. There's another new section, which is the latest from celebrities. A thing that was missing here is there was no genre of the content that the celebrities were presenting. So probably there could be like a pill or something to indicate the genre, and so the user could better navigate into them. Now he finally goes and he watches the IPL. There's this watch and play feature which engages users and also incentivizes them to watch more. But once the sports season is over, the stickiness factor that's associated with this feature would actually diminish. So another recommendation here would be to have a similar sort of shared experience across content that would be movies and TV. And I'll talk about that in detail later on. He finally reaches back home. He goes to take rest and his daughter just comes and starts opening the app. Now she doesn't know there's this kids toggle and she just started seeing all the content and she's exposed to all the content. Intuitive recommendation here could be actually an auto-suggest pop-up, which could be like, okay, you're seeing and searching for more of a kids genre movie. So maybe turn on the auto toggle immediately instead of going to the menu and actually doing that. So there's one more use case. So Rahul's mother actually comes to stay with them for a few days. And now she is actually finding very hard to navigate and go to the shows of her genre and her liking. And there could be something very similar to Kids Toggle for senior citizens. And it could be basically curated for people with above 50 years of age, according to the content that they like to consume, and also related to like their navigation and their suitability. Moving ahead, these are the six sets of features that I came up with from my observations. And I used RISE and Kano model for prioritization. So RISE is basically a model which takes into account four factors: reach, impact, confidence, and effort. Reach is the number of customers that it's going to reach. Impact could be defined by the company, but it's mainly related to the business impact, which could be conversions, clicks, subscribe users, etc. Confidence could be the balance between intuition and data. So with data, we have more certainty. With intuition, we know that it might work. And effort is actually the cost part of this. The other three are the benefit side of the equation. So effort could be in the person months or what is the actual effort that will be taken to implement this feature and launch it. Kano model is, however, based more on the customer side and what factors could actually be the basic ones, what could be the performance ones, and what could be more delightful to the users. And based on the combined analysis from these two models, I came up with a priority list, and I'll be actually talking about the first three here. So push notification is something that's easier to implement because it's already been done. And one thing could be like currently the push notifications are about the shows, but not about something that the user is already watching. So if I'm already watching a TV series such as Roar of the Lion, I am totally interested when the new episode comes out. So that's something that's a clickable notification for me, and like compared to something that's just informational. Also, if I'm watching something or I've recently finished watching it, I'll be more interested about trivia and more likely to engage with this notification. So it's a trivia about a show, say, I recently watched. So these sort of notifications could be done. The senior space is the, I also named it Mummy Papa Toggle, but yeah, the senior space is actually something similar to the Kids Safe Toggle. It could be placed right above it. And it is something that the seniors could just turn on and consume it. So it will have all the contents because people could like to watch every sorts of content, unlike kids. But it will also have like larger icons so that they can better navigate, maybe audio guided search. And also there's one more suggestion, which is easy pausing after every few like 20 minutes or 30 minutes to say like rest your eyes, drink water or something to have a more healthy way of watching for the senior people. The opportunity space, it's something I actually guesstimated. So like India has 560 million users and 6% were like above 50 age who were actually internet users. actually projecting the similar percentage to the Hotstar monthly users, we kind of get 18 million monthly users. And the paying subscriber base is somewhere around 0.03%. So there's 0.54 million paying subscribers. But then this is not the only opportunity space. There's also this untapped opportunity of around 33 million that we can target and actually bring them inside our funnel with using the senior space and a targeted campaign for them. The another feature, which is like one of my favorites, is Hotstar's Party. So there's a compete app in the market, which is actually an extension called Netflix Party, but it's very, very limited. It just allows like simultaneous watching and a chat, basic chat option. This is a more refined version of that, which would actually transform the content consumption experience to the experience of the entire experience of watching with family and friends. So here, like friends are watching Dil Bichara together. And a use case for this would be, say, Rahul has to go to Dubai. Now, they can't go out to watch a movie on weekends. So they just sit together and watch the movie. Now, here, Rahul is watching the movie with his wife and daughter. They're back in Bangalore while they're just watching something together and chatting and also sharing and playing games. So it is actually a something sort of a experience for them rather than just going and... Even in current scenarios, when like people, less and less people are actually going out to watch the movies, I feel this is a very good alternative. And there could be other things that could be added here, such as like Bollywood quiz or say something of TV series trivia, etc. I also did some primary research to actually come up with this.
Ananya, so sorry to jump in. I think we're a little over time. In case this is your last slide. Would you want?
I'll just briefly cover the
wrap it up. Yeah. If you could just wrap up within the next 30 seconds, that would be awesome.
Sure, I'll do that.
Awesome. Thank
you.
So
I did primary research, which included a survey as well as an interview of like 20 participants each. And the main insights that come were, they were very affirmative to the idea of a shared movie experience. And they also like the idea of a senior toggle when just suggested with the idea. And currently, they associate Hotstar as a sports platform mainly. The secondary research is again like about age profiling and also how Hotstar directly correlates with how Hotstar popularity directly correlates with IPL. Yeah, thank you.
Awesome. Thank you so much for that deck. Shovit, just one point before you jump in. I'm pretty sure as the pandemic hit in, shared experiences or shared viewing or, you know, recreating that movie experience is something that you guys would have definitely brainstormed. So would you want to jump in to maybe what are some challenges or if you, whatever you can share your thoughts on that, that would be amazing too. But yeah, over to you for the feedback as well. Any questions?
Yeah, I'll actually... Talk to the shared experiences piece in a little bit. There's actually a bunch of things that have been happening internally in trying to build for that. And we're trying to figure out what's the right way to launch it and trying to figure it out. But we'll get there in a quick bit. So firstly, just wanted to thank Ananya for the deck. I think it was extremely detail-oriented. I thought it was great. I did feel, so one is that I saw new slides in today's deck, which were great. Good initiative, so which I hadn't seen
reordered.
Earlier.
So they were reordered, actually.
Okay. No. That's all right. It's not an issue. It's fine. But thanks for presenting those. The second was that I felt we could have focused a bit more on retention. I understand that there's a lot of problem statements to solve for on onboarding and activation and a lot more there. But just trying to figure out what can make the biggest impact on retention, I think, that is something which is useful for us. And really appreciate the effort to try and get some insights outside of the Hotstar ecosystem, right? In terms of search trends or looking at age groups and looking at distribution of content and their consumption patterns. So I think that was pretty good, Ananya. I have a question for you. And the reason for this question is because it's you've made the suggestion a bunch of times, right? Let's call it the Mummy of a Toggle because I just love the name. What do you think is the adoption of such features like? Because typically, and I'm sure you guys have used apps as well, like how often do you really go into a hamburger menu? How often do you choose to interact with something in a hamburger menu? And even if you've done it once, do you really remember to do it a second time? So do you really think the any toggle that we put inside the hamburger is going to have the kind of impact that will move the needle for you?
Okay, so there were two aspects that I was thinking about. The first is niche targeting. So usually people do a lot of niche targeting for different age groups, but seniors are something that are not usually targeted. And I feel in terms of the new wave of content consumption, seniors are also moving to OTT platforms. So in most of the households, like traditional TV is being replaced. And one of the major traditional TV viewers are senior people who are just staying at home and watching TV. So now they are moving to the new platform. And if it's marketed as something that's just, positioned for them, I feel they will use it. I'm not sure of the kind of impact that it would have, like the kind of conversion that it would have, but it would definitely appeal to that segment. And again, the second thing that is there that I was thinking in mind was the kids toggle is more positioned for making the content safe for kids. So the users are parents and not kids. But here, it's also, again, I would say the users would be the middle-aged parents or middle-aged, sons and daughters of them saying that, okay, say, now it's your time to watch. Let me just enable this so that it's easier for you to watch. And the additional features that I recommended for the voice navigation, voice-guided assistant, larger icons and maybe taking breaks is something that's useful to, have a more digital well-being sort of experience. So this could also be positioned as something like watching in a more healthy way or watching like without hurting your eyes. So that was my thought process.
Got it. All right. Thanks so much, Ananya. Super helpful.
Thank you. Yeah.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Ananya. All the best. And I think we can still, yeah. Okay. Awesome. And we'll give Shobhit a couple of more minutes to go through those, his thoughts on those. Shobhit, at the end of it, do you just want to share, you had a look at the other slides as well, and even these three decks, maybe not pinpointing, but any general feedback for folks who are looking to, build more decks in the future, or even just general interviews, those who are transitioning, those who are just learning, any general feedback from what you've seen so far?
Sure, Saz. Just before I start talking about this, if you hear any audio distortion or break, just chat, so send me a message and maybe I'll switch off video for a bit and then we can proceed with this. I think all the decks were really good in terms of trying to identify some problems to solve and then proposing solutions to try and solve them. And outside of the data that, say, my team and I are exposed to, that we're looking at every day.
Shubhra, I think yeah, we lost your video and audio.
I should be back now. I'm sorry about that.
Yeah, we can hear.
I got the feedback, so I killed video for a quick bit. I should be back on in a minute.
Yeah, fair.
But outside of the Hotstar ecosystem, given that people don't have access to internal Hotstar data, I thought that there was a really good attempt at trying to find out what the insights are from the market and what are the areas that where we could make an impact. So I think that was particularly good. One area where I felt we can focus on a bit more, right, is the two things that I'd mentioned earlier. One was around a lot of these problems are actually being solved by some company or the other, whether it's within the OTT space or outside of it. And it's usually a great idea to take a cue or to take a learning from how others are doing it, right? And then let's critically analyze whether it's working for them or not, whether there's a reason for it to have been tried and not been done before. I think that's always a good thing to keep in mind whenever we're picking a user segment to try and solve a problem for or anything on those lines. And the other thing, which I strongly believe we should start putting a lot of focus on, not just for these decks, but in general for most things, is that it's always a good idea to try and talk about our solutions and then speak about the objective metrics that those initiatives will move, right? Are we looking for a higher frequency Are users going to visit our app more often by virtue of those features? Are we looking for more time spent per session, right? Because users were able to find the content that they care about faster, right? And it could be any of these L0, L1, L2 metrics. I think these key results typically are a great way to help assess the canvas of initiatives that are available to us, and then pick what is the right thing to move the needle on, and then move forward.
Great point. Thanks so much, Shobhit. Shobhit, we'll probably give you, say, 5 minutes to just go through, you know, your thoughts on the three decks, and then maybe we could announce the winners right after that. And then we could jump into the fireside chat, if that is okay.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
Awesome. So while we wait for Shobhit to quickly put down, you know, the final tally together, once again, all the best to the finalist, and we'll quickly be putting out the next month's teardown as well. So in case you guys want to participate, that would be awesome. I'll quickly share my screen and open up the Slido poll. Just a minute. Yep, you guys can see my screen, right? So while we wait, I think we have about 8 questions here. So if you guys could jump into these questions, and if you have any questions for him, please could you add it in? I don't think we'll be taking in specific questions, but anything around his journey, anything you guys would like to, you know, something interesting that you found on Hotstar that you'd like to ask about, any general things around growing in a PM career, that would be awesome. One other interesting thing is most of you all who've been following Product Folks right now, and I think while you joined us earlier, Alan did share about the summit. So in case you guys are interested, in case you haven't signed up already, happy to share like a coupon with you guys on the call, which will be valid during the session of the call or maybe an hour after that. We have almost confirmed a live growth model session, which should be very similar to this, but from the other side. So essentially, a director of product from one of the leading consumer apps will be walking us through a couple of case studies. And this is apart from all the panels and keynotes that we've already announced. But that should be interesting. So it'll be a live Google Sheet solving a problem on the go. That is something I'm personally excited about. So how do companies, especially consumer companies, go about building growth models. I think a version of this, Akash from Hotstar had, you know, walked us through a 6-step framework about a month ago. So this would be interesting to see. So in case you guys haven't signed up already, Alan, do we have a coupon that we could share with all of them here in case you do have one? Also, guys, yesterday, I think we announced that the keynotes are free. So in case you haven't signed up already, the keynotes by Ritesh, who's from Oyo, as well as Nitin from Zerodha, those keynotes are free. So do check out. I think the link is right here. Alan, if you could share the Bitly link in the chat section, that would be awesome. Shobhit's back as well.
Yes. Hi. So, I've just shared the link on the chat section. Yes, Shobhit's back.
Awesome. So with that, I think building up some jingle. I don't have a jingle here, but over to you, Shobhit, and if you could walk us through some feedback and the winner section.
Sure. I think I don't want to be repetitive about it in terms of feedback. There's a bunch of things that we've shared in terms of what we thought was really, really good about the decks, and I think honestly everyone made a great attempt at trying to contextualize the problems that they were solving for. For this session, I felt that Himanshu's presentation stood out in the context of the problem statement that we were trying to solve for, and that was my pick from my side to speak about it first and foremost. But what I do want to spend some time talking about is what went behind it in terms of what are the things that worked. One is that there was a lot of coverage specifically focused on engagement and retention, right? which was beneficial to try and get an overview of what are the areas that we could drive impact on, right? And what particularly stood out in that deck is on one of the slides, that attempt, right, to just try and look at, okay, across all of these initiatives, where can we drive the most amount of impact? And it sits really well with that entire model of, well, there's decisioning and then there's viewing, and then you want to set up this virtuous cycle, right, of a consumer arriving at a decision and then making a choice to view content, and then after that deciding about something else and then going ahead to view content again. I think nailing that virtuous cycle down is critical to OTT engagement and retention. And I think that really stood out in terms of what are the things that we really should be doing specifically to solve for engagement and retention. Across all the decks that we looked at today, and even the other ones, right, which for the lack of time, we weren't able to get on board to have present to around the 80 people who joined. Across all the decks, there were niche problem statements that were picked up, or there were other areas that were really analyzed, and kudos to the folks who really dug deep into them with the market analysis and the surveys as well. But just looking at engagement retention specifically, just looking at what is the core growth loop that I want to power up and accelerate forward, and what are the key things that we could do in terms of what metrics can move. I think for this discussion, for today's problem statement, it was Himanshu. So congratulations for that. But just from my side, I think I would love for everyone who's put in the effort to make the decks. I'm happy to share my contact details and even have a discussion over email or LinkedIn for any questions that they might have or any suggestions that they might want to send in directly or get some feedback on. So I am super open. I think I was sharing with you, Suhas, before we started this interaction, that I was honestly pleasantly surprised with the quality of input that people put into this. Like Corey, for example, she told me that she's a student. Like when I was a student in college and someone asked me to put a deck together, I'd probably do it 2 hours before the assignment due date. Actually, I wouldn't. I'd just go and present. It's my group mates who would go make the deck for me. But yeah, I mean, this is massively impressive. It's phenomenal to see the community putting in so much. And I am happy to give back in every way possible and contribute in every way possible as well. So thanks everyone for sharing your time and effort.
Awesome. Thank you. Thank you so much, Shobhit. That is awesome. And I completely agree with you. I think seeing the level of decks, I think from even like the first one to second, I think great effort, guys. And if you have any ideas on how we could involve more people, so we've tried to increase it from a 60-minute to a 90-minute session so that we can get more feedback and like get the top three. But love the effort that you guys are putting in. And what we are trying to do in the longer term is to create more opportunities also through this, and also help you guys actually put that thinking into place. So if you guys have any ideas on how we could improve this, and it's just our second one, and I hope this one was better than the previous. That is the metric that we are tracking. So if you guys, we'll be sharing a quick feedback form at the end. But Himanshu, congratulations. And Ananya and Gauri, thank you so much for participating. You won't go empty-handed, because thanks to the Hotstar team, they just confirmed that you will receive some swag. So the TAs will get in touch with you. And thanks to Shobhit, thanks to the entire team there. Hope that's just a little add-on for you guys. But yeah, and definitely keep the focus on the learning, and hope it was super useful for the other folks as well. Since we have 15 minutes left on this call, Shobhit, quickly jumping into a couple of questions that we've got.
Guys, before that, I would just like to give a quick shout out to the top six. We had actually Ananya, Gauri, Himanshu. Apart from these people, we have three more people. Akanksha, whose last name shares with Ananya. I don't know if they're sisters.
Akanksha.
Akanksha and Megha and Ankit Mahodra. So if you guys are here, shout out to y'all. We'll figure out a way to give a shout out on Twitter if possible. And I just want to mention the dates for the upcoming event, which I'll do in the end. Let's go on with the questions.
Awesome. Do add it in the chat section as we go along, sure. So in case people are interested. So guys, just shared the Slido link. If you have any more questions, we already have 10 questions, but if you have any more questions and if you could help upvote, because we might be able to pick only a couple of them. So do upvote the guys in the question that you think interesting. Anything around, you know, Shobit's career or anything, you know, specific to product management that you might have, happy to take that up. So Shobit, jumping right in, I think I'll pick the most popular ones. First one's anonymous. But it's interesting. It says Hotstar is known for breaking records of concurrent users. For someone who's a new PM, do you guys share a little more about your system design? I think it's a little more technical. I think, is there some way like a lot of us can follow that?
I'm wondering what's the best way to answer that question. I guess I can try and give you a quick lay of the land in terms of how we think about our infrastructure, our services, our pods, right? So at the very heart of our service, right, what's core to our service is video streaming, right? We want to be able to ingest video at scale. We want to be able to deliver video at scale, right? And live and video on demand are both very, very different technical challenges, right? With live is essentially something that's happening right now and it's being streamed in real time. Video is something that's hosted somewhere and then it's being streamed to users, right? Both come with a very, very different set of challenges. So we've invested a lot in building our infrastructure up to the extent where we can support the scale on these events. Of course, live is where originally last year you guys must 5 million odd concurrent viewers, what we had, and that was huge. Similarly, even on VOD, we've actually seen a lot of consumption in terms of number of users consuming content, the affinity that our fans have for star GEC shows, or the minute a big movie launches, or even it becomes free for that matter, the number of users who try to watch it on the first day, right? We've seen this happen. So for example, recently, Dil Bechara, for otherwise sad reasons, was of course in the news, and it was, in terms of viewership, it is the biggest movie that this country has ever seen, right? In terms of the number of people who watch this movie on day one, which is the day of its release, right? And these are records that we've supported by virtue of investing in heavy systems engineering around video ingest and delivery. That's at the heart of what we do. Just one layer above essentially lie services such as our content management system, our user and identity management system, right? Our data platform. These are all platforms that allow the user-facing product services to function better. And that's really where we get into growth, which is the second pillar of what Hotstar is trying to work with, right? So it's core, growth, and monetization. These are the three core pillars, really. And within growth, you then have things like personalization, recommendations, all the things that we looked at in today's decks, right? Our discovery is a part of our growth effort as well. And what we're trying to do there really is just trying to make this a sticky service such that if you start watching content on Hotstar, how do we get you the next best content to watch? How do we get you on the platform, say 10 times a month or 20 times a month, or all the mind space that you have for entertainment consumption? Does Hotstar have an opportunity to be that for each and every user at a highly personalized level? I think that's really the core focus with growth. And that's where we use ML for recommendations. There's a lot of work that goes behind building out growth models using data science, retention frameworks. And that's where the data platform really comes into its element to help us do all of those things. And at the final end, right, the last pillar is our monetization systems, which are, we're currently monetizing via ads, we're monetizing via subscriptions. So a lot goes into optimizing our payment flows, into our renewal flows. A lot goes into developing for ad targeting systems, ad delivery systems, and even reporting back to our clients. So I think this is really how the org is laid out from a product and engineering perspective. This is the least technical version that I could share with you this call, but happy to discuss it in more detail.
Awesome. Thanks so much for sharing that. next up and suddenly jumping right up is more about how you've, you know, thought about your career. So I think we did cover a little bit about that initially, but how did you break into product and how has your journey been since then? And how did you, you know, how was your transition into Hotstar? So what's the story like?
Okay. Nothing too fancy there. Hotstar is my first job. Prior to Hotstar, it's been my own startups for almost 9-10 years. And at Hotstar, of course, the areas, the people that I'm working with, the teams that I'm working with, and I have some oversight on are, as I was mentioning, it started out with personalization. That's what I got into Hotstar for. And very quickly from personalization, it basically grew adjacently towards looking at what's happening on the data platform and analytics as well, because that was core to personalization. Quickly moved adjacently again to, hey, we're getting all this data, we're doing all of this personalization. How can we funnel growth? How can we funnel our marketing technology by virtue of leveraging all of this information that we have? So it kind of grew into a leading growth role. And then another adjacency was that, well, we just want to know our customers better. We want to know our users better. And we want to create a system that can help the entire organization understand customer preferences, user preferences, and identity better. So it kind of just grew into that ambit as well. And I'm working with a team of really capable product leads and engineering leads who are delivering, firing on all cylinders across each of these pods that we mentioned. So that's been my brief journey at Hotstar. Towards the end of the year. And yeah, it's been a lot of fun. Hotstar is, it's a rocket ship. Things change very quickly. Goals change very quickly and they're always audacious. So that's been very interesting. Prior to Hotstar, I've spent some time, as I was mentioning earlier, on my own startups. I spent some time in the supply chain industry, building solutions and location-based intelligence for deliveries and warehouses. Spent some time in the social messaging space, trying to build P2P communication with a lot of offline embedded features into it. EdTech has been something I've spent significant time on. Almost 4 years of my life have been on EdTech, building solutions for the big four publishers like McGraw-Hill, Scholastic, nice. Et cetera. And largely what I was doing for them was product solutioning and architecting what their solutions could look like, their go-to-market strategies would look like. And I even briefly taught debate to students in schools and colleges. This is something I started out right out of college. And yeah, I'd finished my engineering in aerospace engineering from IIT Bombay. I have done nothing related to it since. So that's me in a nutshell. But I wouldn't say that, and I'm sure most people on this call already know, there isn't one standard path to take, right? It isn't about that. It's more about what journey you take up and what are the learnings that you take along with you as you're on that journey. I don't think that this isn't like school, right? Or this isn't like, hey, let's go finish off. I can share my thoughts on the presidential debate in a bit, Nathan. But this isn't like school that, hey, let's finish 12, let's finish in engineering, let's finish MBA, and there you're in a consulting job, right? It isn't that at all. It's more about the unique things you keep with yourself. And there are so many different things that can make PMs effective. There are so many different perspectives that can make PMs effective. And I don't think, especially when it comes to the scale of Hotstar, and this is a learning that I have taken from Hotstar to wherever I might go next, whether it's my own ship or whether I'm joining a team. I don't think it's about what makes a good PM. I think it's about what makes a good PM team, because you need to strike that balance. And you want to try and get people with different kinds of perspectives, because you're never building for just one user. You're building for user cohorts. You're trying to imbibe different perspectives. And what you don't want is the least common denominator. What you want is, again, right? You don't want to be stuck in a local maxima. And the only way for you to do that is to have qualified perspectives from people who've come from very diverse backgrounds. So I think product management is more about org building as opposed to what this one person's journey or history or career graph has been.
Very interesting. Very interesting. No, especially and since you guys are building so many personalization products as well, you know, how do you keep your personal biases outside of, you know, building for a larger cohort? That's super important. In your journey, you shared you jumped from, you know, being a founder to a lateral senior hire at, you know, at Hotstar. So the story there is, did you know someone already? How did you make that? I'm pretty sure it was not on the website that, hey, there's this position and I'm applying. So
yeah, I have been lucky for the one time in my life when I was looking for gigs. I was able to rely on a network of people to try and make the outreach. In Hotstar's case, it was kind of funny. It was actually a mentor of mine who put out a tweet saying that he knows of a team that's looking at acqui-hire opportunities and even looking at individual opportunities. And someone from the talent acquisition team responded to that tweet over there. So I recognize the privilege that goes behind that, and also the fact that I was lucky in terms of getting the right connects and being able to talk to a lot of people. But it was an enriching process. What we've done since, especially at Hotstar, is that we just tried to make our process a lot more accessible, right?
Okay.
The idea isn't for people who have references alone to really try and get in, right? But yeah, of course, we do want to try and maintain, like, we have this concept of a bar raiser, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where our intention, and as tall an order as it might seem, is that every person that we try to get in must raise the bar on the people who are here already, because we constantly want to grow and be better and better as a team, right? So we have a really high bar for hiring, but we've taken great strides in making that process extremely accessible. Like, for example, one of my first feedback to you guys was that, hey, if people are going to put in the effort to analyze the Hotstar product and come back with suggestions, I'm more than happy to get them into a first round.
Exactly.
Skip the screening round completely. So yeah, we're super open. We want to talk to as many people as possible, and we don't believe in siloed hiring. I don't think Hotstar has any bias for so-called premier institutes or any of those things. We are looking at applications on merit and what people are able to bring to the table.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I want to keep that for the last line of the thing, but since you've announced it, guys, whoever's still on the call, if you heard that, take the cue and definitely, you know, just like level up. All of you guys are doing a great job already putting in this effort, but yeah, take the cue and you know what to do next. So yep, thanks for sharing that journey. I think, Shobhit, just a couple of more questions that we have on Slido. I'll pick maybe two more that are right on top. Something that's interesting is around the Hotstar product is, have you ever considered adding a live chat to increase engagement? Is this something you're thinking about, or any challenges?
Yeah, we've actually experimented with live chat quite a bit.
Okay.
And in fact, it's actually available for everyone to view these days since IPL is on. Mm-hmm. We actually have had this comment and live chat feature under various forms of iteration for the last year and a half.
Okay.
And the reason for us to pick live sports was because that's where we were seeing the highest amount of concurrency. So the chances of you and your friends being online at the same time watching the live match is the highest, right? As opposed to, say, watching Avengers Endgame, where the time that Suhas is watching it and Shobhit is watching it, they don't need to be the same, right? Because there's no urgency to watch it at the same time. It's not live. Mm-hmm. So that's the reason why our efforts were focused on live. And to try and circle back to one of the questions, Suhas, I think you raised originally at the start of this conversation, we are experimenting with not just live chat, but also trying to make it a more social and a video-based experience, which is something that we should think about soon. And yeah, feedback noted. I think it's anytime we do these things, right? There's a lot of feedback to be got. There's a lot of learning. It's not something that we force upon users. So if you guys look at it, right, it's kind of optional and it's only for users in portrait mode. It's only on Android. Like I had a question earlier about why is it not on web? So the reason it's not on web is because we need to have proof in the pudding, right? We need to have something where the largest customer base is on Android and we see that more users are using that experience because they just love it, right? And what are the kind of tweaks that we need to make to it? There could be many. It could be that, hey, right now the chat is noisy. Everyone's just saying Dhoni is God, right? Or everyone's just saying that Kohli is awesome, right? This is all that you see in the chat right now. Mm-hmm. But maybe we could make it more informative by providing more cricket insights, by providing more match insights. Or maybe we could make it more social so that you only see the messages coming in from your friends and it feels more like a closed room chat. So there's different vectors for us to optimize on. And yeah, we're figuring out what are the best ways to do it. I don't think it's a home run either way. So sure. we'll figure something out soon.
For sure. Yash and Divyanshu, in case you guys have, I see like two really good points. If you could, you know, go deeper into that and share some thoughts with Shobhit, I think he'd love to hear more on that.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm available to chat. I mean, while there's different leaders associated with the feed experience and even the social experience. But yeah, more than happy to discuss and understand and get feedback, especially any ideas that the team here might have.
Awesome. I'll probably pick one last question. I'll club a couple of them. We spoke about, you know, we saw the decks today. At Hotstar, how do you guys do it differently in case you were to build out a new feature or, you know, brainstorm a bunch of ideas? Say, you know, you've got 10 ideas from today's. What is this process really look like from, you know, your side? Second is very similar to that. But in that, somewhere down the line, like you mentioned, you know, you see the best things that are happening with, say, you know, competitors, OTT, even if not OTT, some other platform. So how do you, you know, look at that? How do you bring in the best features, what are working for them into your product? So just, you know, a combination of these two questions.
Okay. I'm going to try and answer the first question, the first part of the question first, right? In terms of how would we go about doing it internally at Hotstar. So for me personally, it's the same as making my investor deck whenever I used to work on my startup decks, right? Where the first thing to understand was always, hey, why? What's the context? Why is this document even why is this document even relevant? Why should I spend my time looking at
building it?
Not these decks, but whenever I put a document together, my CPU tells me, why should I give you my time, right? So it's important to very succinctly, within maybe a line or two, explain and enunciate why this initiative or this problem or this artifact is important. So that context is super critical. And the reason I said it needs to happen within a couple of lines is because it forces you to be razor sharp in terms of what's the problem that you want to attack. I think almost 30% of the job gets done within those first two lines because you've spent the time honing it, vetting it, sharpening it. And that really, it buys in all the audience that you're working with. The next thing that we spend a lot of time doing is that we try and understand the potential for impact, right? We try and understand, okay, out of all the users that we have, we believe that 60 million users will get impacted by this. They will get impacted to this extent. And yeah, that gives us some idea of an impact analysis, which helps us then dive into, well, clearly this is important, right? It's basically saying that, hey guys, I'm going to do like X, Y, Z. It doesn't matter what X, Y, Z is. But at the end of it, I'm going to give you 5,000 brownies or a lifetime supply of brownies, right? And now, independent of what I was asking you to do, if you like the reward, if you like the outcome it's going to drive, right?
Yeah.
You're interested. And that I think is key because if you if we don't have the same alignment on whether the outcome is worthy or not, or whether the output that we're looking for is worthwhile, is worth chasing or not, then all the discussions that we're having internally are just details. It doesn't matter. Right. So I think aligning on that is super important. And to one of the questions that I saw earlier on, hey, what about stakeholder management? Mm-hmm. I think the first two things that I mentioned are exactly what stakeholder management is about, which is aligning on the principle, mm-hmm. aligning on the opportunity, right? And then we break it down into, well, here's the user research around this, right? Our design teams need it. And then we break it down into, well, here's the benchmarks, our product teams need it, that here's how other companies have solved for it, right? And then of course, there's a lot of ideas and pitches that come in terms of how we could potentially solve this problem. And then it comes down to just defining the success metrics, what I spoke about earlier, the L0s, the L1s, the L2s,
yeah.
Right? So that's the process at a very high level that's followed at Hotstar. And yeah, the idea isn't to be rigid in terms of process. Process mm-hmm. is only meant to help us move faster. It's not supposed to get in the way.
So we
do make tweaks as and when needed based on how fast we need to move. But this is the overall structure that we try to follow with the work that we do.
Awesome. Bunch of more questions coming in, but we've just crossed our time. So I think it's almost been close to two.
What's this with everyone wanting me to join Twitter? Like,
yeah,
I have stayed away from social media for the longest time. I'm not on Instagram.
But yeah, I mean, there's always a time when maybe today is your day to, you know, make that debut. But yeah, no, that was just like, we were just kidding around, but whichever platform you're most active on, if you could share, or even if it's email, how would you like others to join you?
Please feel free to connect with me on LinkedIn. And I will try to respond to messages as frequently as possible. The best way to communicate is over email. And my personal email address is best. I can actually put it out over here.
Yep, that would be awesome.
gmail.com. So that's me.
Perfect.
And that's a good way to reach out to me. And forgive me for being a social pariah, not being on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. And maybe if that changes, I'll put up a note.
No, that's fine. I think with the social dilemma coming out on Netflix, you're on the brighter side of things right now. So no worries at all.
Yeah.
But yeah, thank you so much, Shobhit. I think taking your time to, you know, 90 minutes on a holiday to spend time with us and actually, you know, give back. I think we had lots to learn from the...
I was more than happy to do it. There's maybe one thing which I want to share.
Yeah.
And it's a personal goal of mine that I am working on as well. So just, I don't want to sound preachy because it's still something under development for me too. Mm-hmm. But I think we've come to a point where there's just a vast account of great reading material. And I would encourage everyone here to try and put some goals for yourselves in terms of this is the kind of reading that I want to do and this is how frequently I want to do it. It could start off with something as simple as one book a month, one podcast that you start following diligently a month, and then see if you can scale that up. Just again, re-emphasizing, it's not something that I have been particularly good at doing myself, but its value can just not be spoken to. It cannot be quantified enough. And yeah, it's something that I try and tell as many people as possible. So eventually someone will also tell me the same thing. And hopefully we will all motivate each other into doing as much of it as possible.
Well, that's a great point that you mentioned. I think this is something that we see across. And the process is super important. Like you mentioned, it could just start with, you know, three blogs, not even one book a month, just 1 to 3 blogs. They just start somewhere really small. And as you said, you know, build up. That is super important. I just shared a link in the chat section. You know, this is in, so I believe completely in building up that process, because most time people start, you know, just as your New Year goals, beginning of the year, 50 books I want to read this year, but 90% drop off. So I think, like you mentioned, this is a great thing. And yep, thanks once again for everyone who joined. Alan has a couple of things that he wants to share with you guys. Thanks once again, Shobhit, and we'll see. We'll awesome. Definitely see something thanks special coming your way as well. We'll shoot that to you after this call.
Awesome.
Thank you so much.
All right, awesome. So just for the record, guys, actually, Shobhit was the one who told us that why not give them the opportunity for the interview. In fact, we didn't even think it that way. Thank you, Shobhit, for that. And this actually makes us to think, you know, which product to pick for the next Teardown, because nowadays getting a product interview itself is a very big deal. Let alone get the job. So thanks, Shobhit, for that. And I'm going to quickly share the link for this month's registration. So go ahead and please register. So just quickly mentioning the dates, we'll be picking the product for this month on the 9th of October. And you will get 3 weeks to prepare for the deck. You can send the deck to us, and similar process. We'll pick the top ones and we'll have another event. That is one that I wanted to share. And also this time we wanted to increase the number of people who send us their decks. It's usually 10% conversion rate. We wanted to increase that. So we thought of what if we can send the Slack link to whoever registers. And you can join the Slack channel, and you can meet other people who also register. You can team up with them. You can work with them to send in your decks as well. That's another thing that I wanted to share. And again, congratulations to the winners. The talent acquisition team from Hotstar will reach out to you in the next 10 to 14 days. I just got the confirmation. So, thank you so much for joining this session. Did I leave anything?
No, I think we're good. I think just
awesome. Great.
Special coupon for the summit. I'll just put it once again in the chat section in case you guys are interested. Also, if I think Alan shared the feedback form. So any ideas that you had, so this is completely volunteer driven. More than 50 people still in the call. So if you guys have any ideas, just like DM us personally. We have a handle that's super accessible. Couple of folks already on this call. So if you just want to, you know, chat, any of y'all are looking to break in, or if any of y'all are already product managers here who, you know, have some ideas on how we could make this better, feel free to reach out. We'll be doing it with another company in the coming month. We're trying to get some swag from them as well to confirm, but that announcement should be out very soon. If you have any ideas, thank you so much. Thank you so much, Manshu. Congrats once again. And to everyone who joined us, thank you so much for joining us. And have a great long weekend if you are joining us from India.
Awesome. Look forward for your decks for this month's Teardown as well. Great. Thank you, Suhas. Thank you, Shobhit. One more time. Thank you,
thanks,
all
thanks,
the six finalists.
Cheers, bye.
See you. Take care. So much, Shobhit. I'll see you around. Bye.